What are you doing, Kim?
I'm getting my extensive CD collection out of my luggage at the moment. As you can see,
we've had quite a day, haven't we?
Yeah, bloody helpful.
The CDs we've got, Maxell Breaks the Sound Barrier, yes, that's marvellous. And we have that one, which is rather cool. This is our room, which is rather nice, in the heart of Beverly Hills. And more of that later.
Location hunting for the film. All this walking about is for Return to Ravenswood, can you believe it? A little film in a little village in a little England. Here we are in Beverly Hills. That's what it's all about.
And this is a very posh street down in.
Okay.
And here's Kim trying to look for the.
We're lost again.
We're lost again, back to the hotel.
Okay. Where are we, Mark? Can you tell me which road we're on at the moment?
Yes,
and then I can find my reference point.
Marino and Robbins.
Do you know where that is on here?
Yes, I'll have a look.
Go.
Kim looking very.
This is me looking.
If you can see actually out here, it's very dark. I don't know if you can see the actual lighting. It's all incredible. It's actually when you're so familiar with the landscape of this town, but when you come here, it just totally throws you. It's not what you're expecting at all. But I've got used to the driving, which is good, just about, with my trusty navigator. Yeah, I think it looks really nice. That's really nice. So we're going to do my scenes probably tomorrow at some point. And the main bulk of filming is going to start about 3 weeks' time in sunny Surrey in England. So, yes, but I think I'm feeling good about it. Feeling good about it.
After Rodeo
first
Drive.
American
person there,
Hello.
Where are we? We're in Rodeo Drive.
Yeah, we are. Just trying to star spot.
Star spot. Can you see anyone? No, no. You can't see anyone.
Hey, there's one here.
Oh. Hi. Hey. Oh my God, it's Carla McKenna.
Yeah.
Hi. Fucking hell. She's top, man.
Yeah.
She's top.
Yeah. Do you want my autograph?
Carla has just asked me to tell you, the viewer, that I got up at 7 o'clock this morning. She's in the middle of the night. I never get up at 7 o'clock unless I'm going to work. So just to prove that I did get up early for once. Although I did go to bed quite early last night. Right, so just to point out that, okay, alright, especially mum, because you won't believe this. So there you go. Here I am in Rodeo Drive, and we've been up for hours. So, alright, that's for the record.
I'm in the Viper Room.
Straight ahead.
Here we are, we're about 75 miles from Las Vegas in the Nevada desert. It actually is not as desolate as you think it's going to be. There's actually stops for people literally every 20 or 30 miles, so you don't run out of fuel or anything. And here's Carla, who's desperate to get a picture of a cactus. But the... did you got it?
Got the cactus.
And how do you feel now that you've got the cactus, Carla?
Yeah, Kim? I've got some dead wood.
Yeah, I bet you've got some dead wood. He's standing here holding the camera, dear.
Is that a... Hello! Hello!
So here we are.
The wow way.
Look at me, such a professional filmmaker, man. I'm going on like I'm making a home video. Having a cigarette because she's actually given up. Yeah, right. Oh, I've really given up. I don't want one anymore. This is about.
Oh, this is just basically the idea behind this is to keep reminding myself how really I have given up smoking and how horrible it tastes.
Right. Okay. We all believe you. To believe this is actually the hotel,
yeah.
Looking like Cinderella's castle. And there's even a roller coaster. Have a laugh. We are walking down the strip and it is all absolutely packed.
Back in the a helicopter.
Thank you.
buddies. Good day, howdy folks, welcome to the ranch. My name's Billy, I'm going to be with you for the short period of time y'all are going to be here, about an hour and 45 minutes. As everybody noticed, the helicopters do not shut down. It shows everybody we are on a time schedule. We got an hour and 45 minutes to do what we're going to do, okay? Right over here, you see the big mountain over here, it's called Spirit Mountain. Look at the main base and bottom, and then look at the next layer of stone. As you look across there, you'll start to see faces in the stone. That's what the Indians saw hundreds of years ago when they were watering their horses. They think that's where their gods are at, so when they die, that's where their spirit goes. As the sun moves, the faces change. It's because of the way the shadows go on the stone, that's what makes them change. This mountain is very well known in Nevada. They got a casino over there called Spirit Mountain Casino. Side of the mountain, he was working over here. Cattle ranches here have gone broke, so everybody's kind of just.
Carla going on a horse ride across the trail. Colorado Pony Trekking Club. Here we are in South Beverly Drive. We're going to be walking walking it down, see what we can find. And, oh look, it's George Murphy. How are you, George?
I've only had a cup of coffee without you bothering me, for fuck's sake.
Is there anything you'd like to say to everyone back home?
Yes, fuck off.
Thank you very much, George Murphy.
John, it's a break, you can't. You have to do a lot of various contracts and what have you. Permit fees, so if I went up to Smallville or something like that, which is shot locally, and I only got one day shoot, probably more than rightly given the sort of level of accident.
George and him walking along Santa Monica Boulevard.
Location scouting on Santa Monica. 3rd Avenue Promenade.
How do you feel, George? You always seem to manage to be in all my films since 1989. How does that feel?
Embarrassing for me, fortunate for Mark English.
Regardless of what your talent is, you've got one take. Okay. But for people who don't want to sing or dance or anything,
he's an actor.
Telling jokes.
Right,
yeah, you want to tell a joke?
We're the Clojure. What's your name right here?
It's a waiver?
Yeah. You want to tell us one too?
No.
Where are you folks from? On vacation, huh?
He lives here.
Oh, you live here?
Yeah.
Hey, I'm here with George Murphy, all the way from
London, England.
Yeah. All right, hold on. Let's do it over. Hold on. What's it?
Action.
I'm Buddy Lewis, and I'm standing here with
George Murphy,
all the way from
London, England.
London, England. Hey, Piccadilly. All right, he's going to do a little something for us. He's going to do a little joke. All right, I'm going to count you down. It's going to be 3, 2, 1, take. You ready? And 3, 2, 1, take. Do it.
How do you get 100 Canadians out of a swimming pool? You say, get out of the swimming pool.
George Murphy's on his way to the top, players. He's on his way to the tippy top with that one. See you in Jolly Old England, player.
I hope so. Good night, Los Angeles.
Yeah.
Wait. I got a joke you would love. How do you get a gay guy to have sex with a woman?
I have no idea.
Shit, the pussy.
Tell the queen mother I said, what's up? She invited me to a party. I couldn't make it last time. But you tell her, Buddy said, hey.
She told me about that.
Yeah, you tell her I said, hey,
she
man.
She was really
upset with me. But tell her I'll see her next year.
All right.
Thanks, George.
All right, man. I appreciate it.
There are no UFOs in Santa Monica. You're crazy if you think otherwise. Come on.
There's one behind you, George.
Oh, we know about that. That's secret government. Only one of us.
Right, we're walking along.
Over 30.
Yeah, over 30 Santa Monica. We're in Santa Monica, Kim and I.
I know it's rather typical of you, but you're actually blocking Kim out of shot and about to be run over.
I don't want to block Kim out of shot because she's far more attractive than I am. Only just.
Hello. Hi, I'll do my usual wave.
Yeah, it does a wave and everything. I'll just go down here with George, who's behind the camera, and do some shooting for Return to Ravenswood and Timequake 2. Or Reversing the Polarity 2, Defying Convention. So, come with us. Thank you.
Patient Drive.
You don't have to film here, mate. You've got a reflection on the back here.
No, it's all right.